September 21st. The Missionary's Predestined Purpose. Now the Lord says, who formed in me from the womb to be his servant. Isaiah 49 verse 5. The first thing that happens after we recognize our election by God in Christ Jesus is the destruction of our preconceived ideas, our narrow-minded thinking, and all our other allegiances. We are turned solely into servants of God for God's own purpose. The entire human race was created to glorify God and to enjoy Him forever. Sin has diverted the human race onto another course, but it has not altered God's purpose to the slightest degree. And when we are born again, we are brought into the realization of God's great purpose for the human race, namely, that He created us for Himself. This realization of our election by God is the most joyful on earth, and we must learn to rely on this tremendous creative purpose of God. The first thing that God will do is force the interests of the whole world through the channel of our hearts. The love of God and even His very nature is introduced into us, and we see the nature of Almighty God purely focused in John 3, verse 16, "For God so loved the world." We must continually keep our soul open to the fact of God's creative purpose, and never confuse or cloud it with our own intentions. If we do, God will have to force our intentions aside, no matter how much it may hurt. A missionary is created for the purpose of being God's servant, one in whom God is glorified. Once we realize that, it is through the salvation of Jesus Christ that we are made perfectly fit for the purpose of God. We will understand why Jesus is so strict and relentless in His demands. He demands absolute righteousness from His servants because He has put into them the very nature of God. Beware, lest you forget God's purpose for your life.